Spent in a miserable way.
U.S. News. U.S. Navy honors first woman naval aviator who died of cancer with unprecedented all-female. The United States Navy conducted its first ever all-female flyover on Saturday to honor Captain Rosemary Bryant Mariner, the first woman naval aviator in the service. Mariner, who died on January the 24th from ovarian cancer, was laid to rest on Saturday during her funeral service in Maynardville, Tennessee. She was 65 years old. An all-female squadron performed the missing man formation during her funeral service. The United States Navy conducted its first ever all-female flyover on Saturday to honor Captain Rosemary Bryant Mariner, the first woman naval aviator in the service. Three of the four fighter jets fly above a graveside service for Mariner at New Oyster Cemetery in Maynardville, Tennessee. Mariner, who died on January the 24th from ovarian cancer, was laid to rest on Saturday during her funeral service in Maynardville, Tennessee. She was 65. The flyover featured four F-18E-F Super Hornets based at Naval Air Station OC in Virginia flying in formation. The four jets flew in formation before one of the planes left the group and climbed vertically toward the sky. The aircraft which does the pull-up honors the person who has died since it represents their departure. During the December the 6th funeral of former President George H.W. Bush, the Navy pallbearers carry Mariner's casket during a funeral service at Norris United Methodist Church in Norris, Tennessee on Saturday. Mariner's daughter, Mary Mariner, carries the burial flag as her father, Tommy Mariner, is seen in the background at the graveside service. From left, Emily Mariner. Her father, Emily Mariner, is comforted by family friend Evan Mitchell while carrying the burial flag. Bush, like Mariner, was a naval aviator during his military service. She knew women could fly airplanes. Her husband, Tommy Mariner, himself a retired Navy commander, said on Saturday. But to have the job of a naval aviator and a professional naval officer went beyond that. And Rosemary understood that. That's why she did. She wanted the door to open and other people to march through. Two women who marched through also attended the funeral to pay homage to Rosemary Mariner, according to this. Chris Geezer, the second female fighter pilot in the Navy, and Joel Drag Ashland, the first female helicopter pilot, attended the funeral service on Saturday. In comments to the press, Geezer recalled how there were many in the military who did not want Mariner to break the gender barrier. It did bother her, Geezer said. She was very focused. It's like, if you are in my way, he'll just go around you. Ashland was Mariner's classmate and her maid of honor. I never saw Rosie get discouraged, Ashland said. The hearse carrying Rosemary Mariner arrived to the graveside service at New Oyster Cemetery in Maynardville, Tennessee on Saturday.
Raindrop,